All right, for rational numbers, we can also think of them as ratios and rates. So like 25 miles per hour, that is a rate and it's also a fraction, 25 over 1, 25 miles over 1 hour. So that's a rate. In terms of ratio, ratio is a comparison of how many of one type of object are associated with some other object. So given a ratio, the actual amounts of each object are not known, but their ratios are. For example, if you're cooking and the cookie recipe says have 9 cups of sugar and 6 sticks of butter, the ratio is 9 to 6. And you write the ratio with a little colon like this. So 9 to 6, that's what the ratio is. It's the same as 3 to 2. Why is that? Remember, 9 over 6, you can make equivalent fraction by dividing both numerator denominator by 3. So it's the same as 3 to 2. In that the number of sugar units is always 1.5 times the butter units. This allows one to make different size batches. And you can see another way to think of a ratio is a fraction, 3 over 2 or 9 over 6. If I divide both numerator and denominator by 3 here, I'll get 3/2. Let's do more examples. So for example, if I told you in order to make rice, I like basmati rice, but people, you can use whatever rice you want to make. Most rice will have the following ratio, 1 cup of rice to 2 cups of water. The reason this ratio is important is because when you cook the rice, you will ensure that the rice will turn out well, whether you're making 1 cup of rice, 2 cups of rice, you know, so different size batches. So here we have different batches. If you take 1 cup of rice, you're going to have 2 cups of water. If you take 1.5 cups of rice, you're going to take 3 cups of water. Always twice the number of cups of rice is how much water you want. So if you have 2 cups of rice, 4 cups of water, 1/2 cup of rice, 1 cup of water. So working with ratios allows you to have flexibility in how much you're cooking. All right, let's take a look at fractions as percentages. So what really is a percentage? A percentage is a fraction where the whole is cut into 100 pieces. That's how you can think of percentages. So for example, say a student got 80% on a test, what does that mean? That means they either got 80 points out of 100, that would be the simplest explanation, or you could have something else happening. Maybe the test was not out of 100, maybe it was only out of 20 points. So if you divide numerator denominator by 5, you'll end up with 16 20ths, which means that the student got 16 points on a 20-point exam. Those are different ways you can interpret percentages. So you can think of a percentage always indicating how many hundredths place you have. So let's try some examples. If I say convert percentage to a decimal number, remember percentage means divide by 100. Division by 100 means you're going to move the decimal 2 places to the left. So you have 1, 2. So decimal point is here. Let's do the next one on your own. I'll give you a few moments. All right. Is that what you got? If not, look very carefully. Percentage means division by 100. So you're moving the decimal from here 2 places to the left. So 1, 2. You got it? All right, try that. 0.3%. Remember, move decimal places 2 to the left. So you're going to have 1, 2. So 0.003 as a decimal. How about 200%? What does that turn out to be? That's 200 out of. Let's take a look at 200%. What would that be, do you think? I'll give you a few moments, see what you can do. Again, decimal place moves 1, 2. So that would be 2. And that makes sense because 200 divided by 100 is 2. So we have just gone back and forth between percentage to decimal. So now let's try going backwards. See if you can convert the following decimals to a percentage. Going backward means you're, instead of moving 2 units to the left, you're moving 2 units to the right, the decimal point. Because now you're going to be multiplying by 100. So here are some problems. See what you can do. Are you pausing? Don't wait for me to tell you the answer, but attempt it, because then you will see whether you got it or not. Eventually, you're going to have to do the problems on your own anyway. All right, so we said that it means multiply by 100, so 1, 2. So that will end up with 56.45%. Next one will become 4% because 1, 2. This one will become 1, 2, so 0.9%. Now 6, the decimal point, when that's not written, that means it's the decimal point is here. So if you go 2 places over, that will be 600%. All right, so we are going now from decimals to percentages, and before we saw percentages to decimals. We can also visualize percentages with the strip diagrams. The strip diagram means when you have picture like that. So if I say this is 100%, then what do you think is that amount? It's 3/4. So the fraction 3 out of 4 is the same as interpreting it as 75%. Do you see why that is? Why is it 75%? Because if the whole is 100 and you have 4 equal pieces, then you have 25, 50, 75, 100. Can you see? So 100 broken into 4 equal pieces. That's like taking a dollar and breaking it into quarters, right? Quarter is 25 cents, right? So 3/4 of a dollar would be 75 cents. So you can think of, if this is 100%, then this orange represents 75%. So if that's 100%, 3 out of 5. So now everything is 20%. Each little box is 20%, right? 20, 40, 60, 80, 100. So 20, 40, 60. So 3 out of 5 represents 60%. All right, there's a few more that I would like you to try. How about that? So look what happened there. So that was my hole. But I am shading 4 pieces out of 3. 4 out of 3, which is same as 1/3. 1/3 is 100%, and 1/3 is 33.3%, because each hole was made up of 3. So again, look, this is 100%, and I have 4/3, which is the same as 133.3 repeating percent, or 1 1/3. So if that's 100% and that's 25%, so 1, 2, 3, so that's 75%. What if I shade, break this last 25% in groups of 5? And so I shade that, what would that be, do you think? So look very carefully. This is 25, 50, 75. This is 25%, but I have 5, 10, 15, 20, 25. So these 2 pieces represent, what do you think? Each strip represents 5%, so you have 85%. Look very, very carefully. 25% broken into 5, so 5, 10, 15, 20, 25. 25, 50, 75, 80, 85. You see that? So the yellow represents 24%. Why? Because this has 10, it's a 10 by 10 grid. So I have 10, 20, 1, 2, 3, 4, 24%. Another way to write 24% would be this way. Why? So again, if you look at the whole, 1, 2, 3, 4, so each bar represents 25%. Again, I can go 5s this way, so 5, 10, 15, 20, 25. And I want 24%, so you only want the 4 bars here shaded out of the 5. So that's another way to represent 24%. It is extremely important that you start getting a skill so that you can actually see it in your head. When you see a percentage, you see a picture. So here's 75% or 3/4. Who can tell us why that's the same as 3/4? Because you are grouping it in groups of 25. So if you divide numerator denominator by 25, the equivalent fraction is 3/4. So if it's 3/4, then it should represent this, right? So that would be 75%. All right, so we can use these visual skills of percentage estimations and solve some problems. Suppose you want to solve 5%, you want to get 5% sales tax on a TV that was sold for $1,240. How do you think we should compute that easily? See if you can do that visually. So here's, I'm breaking the percentages. So we have 100%, so 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 100. So I have 100% and I want 5%. So this last box of 10%, I can go 5 and 5 will make it 10%. I only want 5%, so I really just want that. This whole amount is 1240. So each box represents 1240 out of 10. Why is that? Because everything is broken in. There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 boxes. So each box is $124. Now, if you look over here, I want $124 out of 2. Why? Because I only want half of it. So that would be $62. So 5% of that is $62. You can always compute it by percentages in using it as decimal and doing all the algebra, but visualizing will allow you to get a deeper understanding of what the percentage is about. So remember, 5% is the same as 1/20. So 1/20 of 1240 is 62. So here's a way to compute it. So you have represented the whole as in percentages, and it represents 1240, and then getting the values out. See if it makes sense. Otherwise, rewind and listen again. So 10 boxes, so 1240 divided equally amongst 10 boxes. Each box gets 124. So this last box has 124, but I only want one piece out of 2. So that gives you $62. So my answer, whenever you solve a word problem, your final answer should always be written in a word. The sales tax on the $1,240 TV is $62. All right, see if you can do this. Draw a picture. I'm going to draw a picture a little bit different to show you another way of visualizing stuff. So instead of doing percentages in the picture, I'm going to say I have $90, and $90 represents 100%. So I need 10 equal pieces of 9. So each box is going to get $9. 100%, which is the whole, represents 90. So each box gets 90 over 10, or $9. So now we're saying 60% off sale. So that means if you have 60% off, so this much off, so you're only paying that much amount. So if you're only paying that much amount, how much is that? That's 40% of the original, or 4 boxes of 9, which is 36 bucks, right? So you have $36 that you're paying for that table. That's a pretty good deal. But you can see how we didn't do any explicit algebra, but we visualized it, right? So you can see how without a calculator, you can compute relatively easily if you learn how to visualize it. So the sale price of the table is $36. So here are some video log questions.